Acid, bases, and salts, and we have covered almost 3 to 4 topics of that. Right now, what we are going to do is, you can see on the board if it is clear to you. We are going to do test yourself box number 10.1. That is on page number 27. One by one, I am going to discuss all the questions, and you have to supposed to do it in your copies. Question number 1 to question number. Okay, the first question is that what is the difference between Arrhenius base and Bronsted-Lowry base? Now, all of you know that what is the difference between that wait a minute, let me set that direction as well. Okay. So, the first one is what is the difference between Arrhenius base and Bronsted-Lowry base. So you must have learned the previous one, so you must be able to know the answer that Arrhenius base is the base which has the tendency to give. I'm discussing number one. Arrhenius base is the base which has the tendency to donate OH negative ion. It is known as Arrhenius base. But what is Bronsted-Lowry base? It is the base which which has, this is Arrhenius concept, and according to the other one, Bronsted-Lowry, it says that which has the tendency to accept that proton. So this one is the major difference between Arrhenius and Bronsted-Lowry. That the concept of Arrhenius, I'm repeating again and again, it should be just like that, you should be mastered that what is the difference between these. Try to listen carefully so that you will be able to read by yourself. Now, the first one is that if Arrhenius says that if we dissolve some material or something that is molecular ion in aqueous solution, means if we dissolve it in water, if it gives OH negative ion, it means it is an Arrhenius base. What is the difference? But the other persons, they say that Bronsted-Lowry say that if the molecule or substance has the tendency to accept that H positive means proton, acceptance of proton, then it is base. So this is the difference. H positive ki baat pe buniyad pe baat kar raha hai dusre wala, and on the base is the concept, general concept ke OH negative ion dissolve kare pani mein. So this is the difference. Number two, what do you mean by neutralization reaction according to Arrhenius acid base concept? So, whilst giving you the examples, I have told you that what is neutralization reaction, the basic thing, neutralization reaction. Neutralization, we are doing question number two. Neutralization reaction is always that when we are reacting, acid with base, salt, plus water. This one is known as neutralization reaction. So this is the concept of Arrhenius acid base concept, that when we react with an acid with a base, the reaction is salt and water. So you can write down the equation. You can also write down some examples from a book as well, and you can solve it. Now question number three. Prove that water is an amphoteric species. This is very important question. You can write down that it has come in 2015. That someone was asking in the previous classes that how we can prove that. So you can easily prove that. You can give the example of two, like you can say that when water is amphoteric, is basically those compound which has a tendency to react like acid and bases as well. These compounds are known as amphoteric compound, means when we carried out some reaction, in that reaction it is acting like a base, but it has a tendency to act like a base at the same time. So these kind of compounds are known as amphoteric, and water is a very big example of all this. Now you can write down that when water reacts with ammonia, NH3, what does it form? It forms ammonium ion and water. Over here, water is acting like acid and ammonia is acting like base. But at some instant, when we have HCl and then we react it with water, what happens? HCO positive plus chlorine negative. Over here, you can see water is reacting as a base. So these two equations comprehend well that water is behaving like an amphoteric. It means you can see I'm using another marker to make it clarify that water is acting like an acid when we react it with a stronger base. And over here, water is acting like a base with HCl, stronger acid. So we have not taken such an acid or base that is more stronger than the other, right? Now you can say that water is acting like acid and base, so it is behaving like an amphoteric species. Number four question. How can you justify that ammonia is Bronsted-Lowry base but not Arrhenius base? Now, according to Bronsted-Lowry, you have explained it well in the equation that it is what kind of base. You can find your answer from the Lewis basis. Now, question number five. State and explain the neutralization reaction according to Lewis concept. Now, the definition acid plus base salt and water was reaction according to Arrhenius concept. Now they are asking neutralization reaction according to Lewis concept. So it's on page number 25 where you can see this ammonium ion and where the adduct formation is going to be formed. So you can say this one is the example of neutralization reaction. So you have to quote this all the formula and structure, and then you have to tell that the adduct formation is basically the neutralization reaction according to Lewis concept. Now, number six, define and give the characteristics of a Lewis acid. Now, there were two points we have discussed in Lewis acid. You have to write it down in this question. Why BF3 behaves as a Lewis acid? You have to quote the example and you have to write down why boron trifluoride is acting like a Lewis acid. Now, last one, water is an amphoteric species according to Bronsted-Lowry concept. What is its nature according to Lewis concept? Now, they are asking that according to Lewis concept, what kind of property water has? Now, you have to write it down according to the Lewis structure. Now, you have to find out the answer and then you have to tell me in the last 10 minutes of the class. Okay? Now, coming towards the next one that we are going to right now do, the basic topic is general properties of acids. It's on page number 27. Okay, Vipin? Page number 27. It's general properties of acid. We are going to discuss general properties. So, whilst we studied the chapter, those students who didn't listen before, please go on your chapter number 10 and just start reading and you will be able to understand it. There were about the table on which there is written physical properties of acids. So, we have discussed very clearly that acids has a number one property was that acid has some kind of sawdust taste, khatta taste, like you can say the taste of lemon, grapefruit, all these can be a little bit quantities of vitamin C or acid, citric acid. Then they turn the litmus paper into red color. This was a big property of acid. The third property was, we were discussing that it has the ability to brew. Corrosion ho jati hai. Number four was that we can check the pH that is under the 7 is considered to be the acid. These were general properties and you can go there, physical properties. Now coming towards chemical properties. Physical properties means appearance. Now coming towards chemical properties, that how these are acids are going to react and which gases and which are the products is going to become. Just like the example I have given to all of you that when acid and base is going to be reacted, salt is formed, water evaporation, so the result is a neutralization reaction. Similarly, we have to find out that what are the other reactions, general reactions that we are doing. So there is a chemical property, first one we are going to discuss, reaction with metal. Now, when we were discussing the previous chapter, no, that was class 9, sorry. Okay, class 10, in class 9, you have studied that metals belong to which group, which period, and what has the tendency, how they can, they are able to do the things, right? So we are going to react with metals. Metals ka general concept ye hai, so whenever we are going to react any kind of metal like sodium, potassium, or any other metal, these are having very, very, you can say these explode. So we need to handle it really very carefully. Like if we are going to handle sodium metal, we need really very carefully use spatula, a different instrument to capture that metal. Okay. Otherwise, it creates a lot of burns on your skin if you pick it up. So metals ki general tendency ye hai ki ye jo metals सारी की सारी हैं ये रिएक्ट करती हैं एसिड के साथ और ये कोई ना कोई गैस लिबरेट करती हैं. सो फॉर अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द रिएक्शंस ओवर हियर. लाइक आई वाज सेइंग दैट सोडियम पोटेशियम एंड कैल्शियम दे रिएक्ट विद डाइल्यूट. डाइल्यूट मींस देयर आर टू टर्म्स. नंबर वन डाइल्यूट, ऑल ऑफ यू मस्ट बी फैमिलियर, एंड द अदर वन इज कंसंट्रेटेड. डाइल्यूट इज अ टर्म इन विच यू एड सम वाटर और उसको आप पतला कर देते हैं. Just like you take sugar and you pour full glass of water, that is diluted form of sugar water. Now concentrated, in which no water is added, as it is. Let's say it is 1 molar. So it is as it is, the acid which is going to be used. Now the reaction we are going to do, it is with dilute acid HCl and H2SO4. Because if we use concentrated acid, they will explode very much and it can cause us on a very large scale destruction, especially sodium metal. Like if you throw a little bit piece of sodium metal in a river, it will explode very badly. It will explode very, very badly. So we need to use very, very dilute acid for the purpose of reaction. Now you can say that zinc, Z capital and will be small. When it is going to react with H2SO4, means H2SO4 is the king of chemical sulfuric acid. आपको साथ में उनके नाम भी आने चाहिए और साथ में उनकी symbols भी आने चाहिए. You should be very clear for that H2SO4. And when it is going to be reacted, zinc sulfate will become ZnSO4. ZnSO4 remaining is hydrogen gas. You can say hydrogen gas, and this arrow upper side, on the upper side of arrow shows that the gas is going to be gas is escaping out from the reaction jar or reaction mixture. This arrow is indicating that. So when zinc is going to react H2SO4, zinc sulfate is going to be formed and hydrogen gas is going to be liberated. Now there is another example that when we react with aluminium, aluminium with HCl. 2, 6. Okay, this is a balanced chemical equation. You should know that 2 moles of aluminium are reacting with 6 moles of HCl. So what is the reaction? Reaction says that there will be 2 moles of aluminium chloride, AlCl3. 2 moles of aluminium chloride with the liberation of 3 moles of hydrogen gas. So these are very important reactions, and in the last year, these are coming almost in every year that you have to write down 4 or 5 chemical properties of acid. So please be very careful. Do practice again and again so that you will be able to write down it clearly. Let's say if I have given you this equation and you didn't write down AlCl3, there will be 0 marks because the proper formula of aluminium chloride is AlCl3, right? These are 2 moles. And these are 2 moles of aluminium, 6 moles of HCl going to react, and then they form this. This was the reaction with metal. Zinc and aluminium are metal, and these are going to react with these acids. So the end product is salt plus liberation of hydrogen gas. So you should keep this thing in your mind. Now there is second one, that how the acids are going to react with carbonyl. CO3- its carbonates and bicarbonates HCO3-1. That how our acids are going to react with carbonates and the compound which has bicarbonate. This is the CO3-2 for carbonates, bicarbonates HCO3-1. Right now we are going to do the example of calcium carbonate. CaCO3. This is compound having carbonate ion. CaCO3 is when reacted with HCl. What happens? CaCl2 is going to be formed. Calcium chloride, and along with what happens? Carbon dioxide gas. Definitely it is going to be evaporated and we will get some water. These are the reactions. If you do it again and again on your notebooks, on your copies, then it will be more beneficial for you. Agar aap zubani inko yaad kar lenge, aapko bilkul yaad nahi hoga. So it's very important you write it again and again on your copies and learn it. So calcium carbonate when reacts with HCl, it is producing calcium chloride along that carbon dioxide gas and water is going to be evaporated. Questions can come. HCl, a salt is formed along with which gas is going to be evaporated. So, okay. So, you can say that carbon dioxide is gas going to be evaporated when we have the acids to react with carbonates. Now, we are taking the example of bicarbonate. We will take the compound which contains bicarbonate, Na, sodium bicarbonate, HCO3. NaHCO3 is also known as the baking soda, which we use in our house. Jise meetha soda bolte hain. That is sodium bicarbonate. When we react it with sulfuric acid, H2SO4, what happens? Na2SO4 salt plus carbon dioxide gas and water is going to be formed. So keep this thing in your mind that whenever acids are going to react with carbonates and bicarbonates, carbon dioxide is the gas which is going to be liberated along with water. And the product is a salt as well. The major thing to be noted that carbon dioxide gas is going to be liberated. Please practice these equations as much as you can so that it will be helpful for all of you. Now, coming towards the third one, that is reaction with bases. It is very simple that when acids are going to be react with bases, what happens? Obviously, it is a neutralization reaction. I am writing RxN is for reaction for bases or with bases. So, it is general conception that sodium hydroxide, it is a base because OH negative is over there. And it is react with a very strong acid. Sodium hydroxide is a very, very good base. We have to react with a good acid. Obviously, a salt is formed. And NaCl, sodium chloride, namak, which we use in the table salt, okay? And water. So the reaction is neutralization reaction. See, base plus acid, salt plus water is the evaporation. Now, another example, copper oxide. It is reacting as a base and it is reacting with sulfuric acid, H2SO4. Obviously, CuSO4, copper sulfate, is going to be produced along with water evaporation. So, this reaction, when acids are reacted with bases, they produce a salt plus water and the reaction is also known as neutralization reaction, right? Now, we have the fourth one, reaction, which is with reactions with sulfides. Now, sulfides are SO3-1 and bisulfides, HSO3-1. Right? You can also write down on the top of the book that SO3-1 is sulfide and bisulfide is HSO3. Similarly, I have written before carbonates and bicarbonates, right? So, you can say that when acids react with sulfides and with bisulfides, what happens? They definitely form a salt and liberation of sulfur dioxide gas happens in this case. Just like example of calcium sulfide, CaSO3 is going to react with HCl. CaCl2 is formed. But what happens? SO2. Sulfur dioxide gas is also going to be liberated and water is formed. So you can say when acids are made to react with sulfides, what happens? Sulfur dioxide is the main gas which is going to be escape out and along with water and salt. Similarly, now we take the example of bisulfide. We will take sodium bisulfite, NaHSO3, when it is going to react with HCl, what happens? Definitely salt, NaCl, NaCl remaining is SO2, sulfur dioxide and remaining is H2O. So over here, sulfur dioxide gas which is going to be escape out, and we can see the reactions of sulfide and bisulfide. There, the fourth one, how much time is, okay, we have question number, now fifth reaction, we are going to do it with reaction with sulfides. Now, how it reacts with sulfides? This was sulfides, S-U-L, there is a difference between sulfide and there is difference between sulfide. Right now, we have done the reaction like CAS, these are sulfides, CaSO3. These are the reactions that is sulfide. Now, we are concerned with sulfide where D is coming. We will take the example where only S is present. This is sulfide, sulfide is SO3-1. Now, we are doing reactions with sulfides. We can say that ferric sulfide, ferric is also known as iron, Fe is for the symbol of iron atom. When it is going to react with H2SO4, what happens? FeSO4 along with hydrogen sulfide gas. In this case, you can say hydrogen sulfide gas escape out, and it has very bad smell, pungent and egg-like smell. Hydrogen sulfide's ability have enabled this reaction is going to be happen in the lab, and we're just passing it out. So, aapko ek bahut buri si smell feel hoti hai. That is rotten egg smell. Just like an egg is going to be expired, the same smell comes from H2S. So, this is the difference that ferric sulfide. Whenever we are saying sulfide D with D, it's S, and we are sulfides, it is definitely SO3-1. So this is the basic difference between sulfides and sulfides, and you must be able to differentiate between it. Now there is an example, there is a box in your book on page number 28, and it is very, very important. It is coming in your papers as well, that what are mineral esters. Now there are three kinds of acids that are very, very powerful acids that are known as mineral acids. Number one is HCl, hydrochloric acid. Number two is sulfuric acid. And number three is nitric acid, HNO3. So these three acids are also known as mineral acids. Like recently it has come in the exam that what are mineral acids? You are supposed to write down HCl, H2SO4, HNO3, and write down the names as well. That HCl is hydrochloric acid, H2SO4 is sulfuric acid, HNO3 is nitric acid. These all three acids are known as mineral acids. Now, coming towards the uses of acids, that what are the important uses in our daily life? That why we are studying it, why it is created. Now, these are very, very easy, and we are going to start. Uses of acid, number one, sulfuric acid, H2SO4. H2SO4 sulfuric acid, I have told you when I started the chapter that sulfuric acid is really very important. Why is it important? Because all the batteries in our cars, all the batteries in our, and that liquid contains this sulfuric acid in it, in diluted form, because it is used to generate electricity. So you can say that sulfuric acid is used for manufacturing different kind of fertilizers. Fertilizers are those which are used for manufacturing of crops, and different compounds are made with it, like ammonium sulfates, and it can use in fertilizers. Then calcium superphosphates are over there. There are many explosives which can be made, like TNT. Trinitrotoluene is made with the help of this. It can explode very on a very, very bigger level. And it is used for drugs as well, for our medicines, for varnishes, paints, dyes. And then it can also be used in the storing of battery. Now coming towards HNO3, nitric acid. It is very important acid because it is used for ammonium nitrate.
Sorry for interruption. My laptop is out of order now, so I am unable to explain it on the board. So we was discussing about the uses of assets, and you can see on open your books page number 28, right? So I was discussing about nitric acid. Nitric acid is definitely using for manufacturing of different kind of fertilizers and explosive paints and drugs as well. And there is another acid which is known as HCl. HCl is used for cleaning different kind of metals, tanning, and in printing industry. It is a very common acid used. Like whenever we have to open our drainage, we use the acid which your mom and brings. It contains HCl, so it is highly recommendable that you use it used karein, dilute karke. Then there comes another acid that is known as benzoic acid. It is a new name for you. It's on page number 29. You people can and you can find out that you can find out that over there benzoic acid is written. Next time I will show you the formula structure of benzoic acid when I will be having the ability to of board. You can write down the formula that C6H5OH means it contains main functional group OH and it has a benzene ring, like it has 6 carbon and H is hydrogen are 5 and OH. So benzoic acid is used as a food preservative. Like whenever we want to preserve something, we just put a tinge of a very little bit amount of benzoic acid and that will getting be safe. Now there is last one, acetic acid. The acetic acid CH3COOH is the formula of acetic acid and it is used as a vinegar. The vinegar which we used in our daily life, apple cider vinegar and the natural vinegar. So this vinegar is containing acetic acid and it is also used for flavoring our Chinese food, especially like when we make spaghettis and things like that, we used it in our food as well. Now there is another topic, natural occurring acids. These are the occurrence of sources from where these are coming. The first one is citric acid. Citric acid is present in all our citrus fruits. Whatever the fruits like that contains citric acid, jo khatte hote hain, like lemon, oranges, grapefruits, all these contain citric acid. Lactic acid, it's contained in sour milk, jo doodh harab ho chuka hota hai, phata hua doodh. Just like the thing which has yeast in it, it contains lactic acid. Then formic acid, whenever you get an insect bite, there is some swallowing and that is due to formic acid. Then butyric acid is in rancid butter, jo butter harab ho chuka hua hota hai. Tartaric acid, it's present obviously tartaric, jisme tartary hoti hai, tamarind, imli, grapes and apples. Then there is malic acid. Malic acid example is of apples. Uric acid is present in our urine and if it exceeds it creates a lot of problem. Then there is stearic acid. Stearic acid is present in fats, in butter and in all oils. So this was all we have done with today's lecture and I am sharing a screen for you all of you in which you can see the homework and if you have any question I will allow you after some time, then you will be able to ask the question. Let me share the homework meanwhile. It's over here. Yeah, hope you all are able to see the screen. Let's test yourself. 10.1 we have just explained. Please try to do it on your registers. And then question number 2, write down chemical properties of acids and write equations for all acids. These are all the reactions, 5 reactions jo maine aapko karwaye hain. You are supposed to do it. Then what are mineral acids? Write down the names with formula. 3 acids hain, aapko maine abhi board pe bhi bataya hai. You have to write down. It's just of 2 mark question. Then question number 4, write down important uses of acids with their names. You are supposed to write down the names as well. That this is not comprehensive, no. You should know that hydrogen benzoic acid is used for what purpose, acetic acid is used for what purpose. Okay, now if you have any question you can ask me. If you have any question, you can raise your hand and you can ask me. And please try to complete this work till Tuesday. Please unmute your mics. Yes, Eunice, do you understand? Elsa, please unmute your mic, bitte.